Danny Lee along with Kevin Lehman. Welcome back to Gwangju, South Korea, the 28 Summer Universiad. We've reached the semifinals. It's Team USA versus Team Russia. Need we say any more? The winner moves on to the gold medal game to take on Germany, which won earlier today 59-49 over Brazil. The loser will take on Brazil. And the United States, after running Lithuania out of the gym in the fourth quarter yesterday on a 15-0 run, Bill Self's team is going to take on a very physical group in Russia. And one of the things that he told us before today's game, Kevin, is the motto for today's game is play through contact, because they're expecting a lot of physical play from these Russians.
Not only a physical team, but a tall team, as they start 7'3" in the middle. Desi Oknikov, and off the bench, Klimenko at 7 foot. Big guards, big back line. Team USA is going to have to use their speed and quickness and get the ball in the open court.
Roberto Chiari, the referee for this contest. Krishna Dominguez and Moritz Reiter are the assistants. So the U.S., they'll be out in their blue uniforms. Russia will be wearing their white and red. Hunter Mickelson in the starting lineup again. U.S. starting lineup unchanged for the second straight game. It'll be 6'10 Hunter Mickelson jumping against 7'3" Andrei Desyatnikov, who actually entered in the NBA draft in 2015. But was not selected. So here we go, semifinal number two, gold medal game at stake, and the Russians possess first. Here's Vikrov off the cut to Ilnitsky, and in the corner to Antipov. Artem Komolov gives away his dribble, Seldon in defense. 4 on the shot clock. Vikrov goes up, it's off the front rim, and Mickelson corrals it. Here comes the U.S., and Ellis leads the charge.
One of the concerns for the Russian staff was not to allow the USA to get their running game going. Good start for Team USA.
Russia, the reigning World University Games champions. 3 players returning from that team in Kazan from 2 years ago. In trouble, Desyatnikov going down the lane to Ilnitsky, going up against Ellis, and it's batted out by Mickelson. 3-pointer off the front rim by Antipov. And Hunter Mickelson with another rebound for the U.S.
Well, the emerging big man, Hunter Mickelson, again, high on the glass. He can rebound in a crowd.
Ellis' shot just rims out, and the rebound is reeled in by Artem Vikrov, who plays for club team Zenit St. Petersburg, which is the club team for the Russian head coach, Vasily Karasov. And here comes Moore off the miss.
Well, Danny, you see Nick Moore, the smallest guy on the court, with the rebound. The guards for Team USA have been excellent, especially on the defensive glass, him along with Mason.
Oh, a head fake, reverse layup, nicely done for Vikrov.
And Vikrov at 6'6". We've seen many big guards in this tournament that Team USA has faced.
Ellis has taken all 4 of the shots for Team USA. That time could not get it over the long arms of 7'3" Andrei Desyatnikov. Antipov fires the 3, and that one buried. 8-14 is Antipov from 3-point range at the games. It's 5-2, Russia with 5 unanswered.
Well, Russia has 4 players that can hit the 3 ball, 2 of them at 6'8".
Nice backdoor cut for Seldon.
I'm the president of the Wayne Seldon fan club as he continues to dazzle this crowd.
18 points per game coming in, number 2 overall in the tournament, also at 59% field goal shooting. Komolov inside to Desyatnikov, working on Mickelson, and draws the foul against Hunter and will go to the line for 2 shots.
Now, no double team when the ball goes in the post to Desyatnikov, because he is not a great scorer. Mickelson has to hold his own, and here's that fast break run out. Ellis punches it through for the first 2 points of the game for Team USA.
Desyatnikov, 8-14 at the line, and misses off the back rim. The Russians came in at 67% free throw shooting as a team. There's a look at Vasily Karasov. His son Sergei played for the Russian team in 2013, 2 weeks after being drafted by the Cleveland Cavaliers. This past season played with the Brooklyn Nets.
And Karasov said, even though this is a semifinal game, because they're playing Team USA, it is like the gold medal game to these players from Russia.
On the near side, Nick Moore, defense by Artem Vikrov. Moore gives away his dribble. 6'4" Russia. Mickelson in the corner, defense by Antipov. Mason drops it off the shoe of Komolov. And the shot clock restarted to 14. Here's a look at RTM Komolov, 8 points per game coming in.
And you can see Vekrov at number 13 just dwarfs Nick Moore, who at 5'9" is one of the smaller players in this entire tournament. He's given away 9 inches in the backcourt.
Seldon inbounds to Ellis, U.S. possession. Frank Mason III on the move to the hoop, big game against Lithuania, tries to get it over the 7-3 Desiatnikov. We talked about him being a rim protector, Kevin. He's going to be a big factor here for Russia.
And Team USA scoring a majority of their points in the paint. It's going to be a little more difficult in this game. Ellis is going to have to expand his game. They're going to need to get some three balls out of Seldon. There you can see that last play. Out of bounds, the ball going to stay with Team Russia.
Just touched by Mickelson going out. RTM Vekrov, and it's kicked, and we'll restart it once more.
Well, Mickelson smelled that one out because Seldon hung up on a back screen.
This one's tipped away by Mickelson again, getting his hands in all over the place. Corner three for Antipov off the side of the backboard. Russia trying to save the rebound, and it will be back to the United States.
One of the things we see in this World University games are long rebounds, and the quickness of the USA guards have been very noticeable in this, as Nick Moore, that time, the littlest guy on the floor, but retains possession for Team USA, and Frank Mason III, also an excellent rebounder for his size.
Here's Moore, rises from three, short off the front rim. Bill Self before today's game praising Nick Moore's defensive effort. Guard from SMU with 6 steals yesterday against Lithuania. Desiatnikov fouled again by Hunter Mickelson. And now Mickelson with 2 first-quarter fouls.
And activity on the USA bench as Landon Lucas comes in. And there's that screen and roll. Nick Moore is dwarfed by the 7'3" Desiatnikov. And they're going to try and do that pick and roll and get that switch and get Nick Moore on the 7'3" center from Russia.
Mickelson only played 17 minutes in the win against Lithuania, but Landon Lucas coming in, the most productive performance yet. 7 points, 9 rebounds in his 20 minutes. The score remains 6-4 after the miss.
Well, Lucas has proved he is not afraid to get in the fray. Physical, frontline defender and rebounder for Team USA.
Yeah, we saw that against Serbia the other day and yesterday against the Lithuanians. Mason leads the charge up the floor to Moore. Seldon looking for Lucas early against Antipov. Seldon rises from three off the front rim. Antipov make a Desiatnikov with a rebound. And Moore tangled up with Komolov, and it will be a foul against the Russians.
Now in the other semifinal game, we saw both those teams, Germany and Brazil, get off to a slow start. A little bit the same in this game as these teams had a day off yesterday, but as Bill Self said, this is a lot of games in a short amount of time.
Yeah, 8 games in 10 days is a pretty brutal thing to ask, especially with the physical nature of international play. Ellis misses on the jumper, so after making that dunk, missing the last 4 shots, rebound off to Russia, still leading by 2.
And also with the USA's guards, they're a little thin up front with in the backcourt, as Brandon Green did not make the trip. Devontae Graham was hurt. Green had surgery in April.
Stanislav Ilnitsky with the 3-point shot. And the Russians now up 9-4. Ilnitsky came in 6-for-13 from 3-point range. Here's Mason, Moore trying to match. And he does just that.
Oh, the guts of a cat burglar. Number 3, Nick Moore. 3-ball, corner pocket.
35% 3-point shooter Moore coming into this tournament game. It's 9-7. Russia on top of the USA. Komolov. And a foul from behind committed by the US.
Great ball movement by this team from Russia. And as Bill Self told us before, they counted one possession and a 24-second shot clock. And there's Moore. Corner pocket. Bill Self said he counted 11 passes in one possession by this team from Russia. They are great ball movement.
Alexander Gudomak coming in, 6'8", to replace Andrei Desyatnikov, 7'3". So a little sigh of relief over on the USA bench for now.
But Gudomak is a better offensive player.
And running in the back door and laying it in is Ilnitsky. He's got 5 quick points for the Russians.
Well, that's the second time Wayne Selden has got caught on a back screen on an inbounds play by Russia. The first time Mickelson bailed him out, but no help on that last one.
Moore looking for the entry, gets it to Lucas. Moore trying another three. This one long, chasing down the rebound, Ellis. Shot clock reset to 14, remember, on the missed shot. Here's Selden, jumps it off to Moore again. Lucas battling inside and gets fouled.
Boy, Landon Lucas comes to play with a set of steel-toe boots today. He's in there in the fray. As you mentioned, excellent rebound game by Landon Lucas against Lithuania in the last contest.
Looking inside, Selden whips it right out to Ellis. And the reverse not there. The Russians up the floor. Artem Vikrov. Vikrov blows right by Moore.
Well, side ball screen has been a problem for Team USA. As Bill Self said, we haven't worked on it much. Nick Moore tried to jump the screen, open up the driving lane, no help.
Ellis on Gudomak, and another foul inside. This will be the Russians' third foul and the first against Gudomak.
Now you see this play up there as Nick Moore just catches a little bit on the hip, but there's three shooters on the right side of the court. Help defense cannot get there. Bill Self wants to ice those screens, but that one coming from middle of the court, difficult to keep it on the side as Moore just caught enough of the screener's body that he got behind. And then the size of the Russian guards at 6'6", Vikrov.
Perry Ellis rolls in the free throw. He's got 3 points, now 7 of 14 from the line at the tournament. LeGerald Vick in for the U.S. at the same time that Viktor Zariashko, the captain, and who Vasily Karasov calls the heart of the team, in for the Russians. Ellis out for the first time today, and on that note, Traylor enters for the USA. 13-9 Russia.
And Bill Self will continue to rotate those 5 post players. And LeGerald Vick has been growing up quickly in this tournament. The freshman out of Memphis.
Out of options, Komolov trying to work it inside of Gudomak against Lucas. 6 on the shot clock. Zariashko, 3-point shot comes up long. Climbing the ladder is Traylor.
Traylor, another guy who's not afraid to get dirty inside, bang with bodies.
Mason with 18 against Lithuania. His first 2 here today, coming in with a 15-point-per-game average here in South Korea. Oh, and the Russians had a clear path to the hoop, but Antipov could not handle the wraparound pass from Zariashko.
Well, the ball screens are causing problems for Team USA, as you mentioned, Danny. Much more physical play in international basketball. Those screens sometimes move a little bit more than they do in the college game. And, of course, bigger, stronger bodies on this Russian team with that great size in their backcourt.
U.S. possession, Mason with Vic running alongside, Ellis Traylor, and Selden the 5. Over on the wing, Selden pawing at the ball to Zariashko, entry to Lucas. Backing down Barinov, who comes on for the first time today, Nikita Barinov commits his first foul. By the way, also something to note, currently on the Russian side of the floor, there still continues to be some dripping from the ceiling here at the Dong Kong College Gymnasium. During the first semifinal game between Germany and Brazil, it was water dripped on the floor. Mason tried to throw it off the back. Now the Russian player to no avail. They put in some MacGyver-like device to catch the rainwater in a bucket, but it apparently is not working as they're mopping up the water in between possessions. And the shot out of the corner for Russia's Ivan Strebkov for his first 2 to make it 15-11.
Russia, like Team USA, has excelled at second chance opportunities throughout this tournament, and there is a great evidence of that.
Step back, Seldon for three, just rattles out. And Strebkov fell flat on his face after the maneuver, taken away by Seldon. Three on two for the U.S. Slings it cross court, Mason to Traylor inside. And here's Vic from 20. And he drains it.
Well, so far, Vic has come off a ball screen for an open shot. We've seen Frank Mason do it. That has been the best offense for Team USA right now, is that ball screen about 12 foot out.
Position inside. Turnaround not there. Zariajko well defended by Lucas and Traylor. Here comes Mason trying to take off the dribble Zariajko. And Russia commits its fifth foul of the quarter.
Well, Frank Mason has that break your ankles move. There's a little in and out that these international players have not seen. Great explosiveness and quickness from number zero there from Team USA.
Mason to the line, a 72% free throw shooter. Had a very efficient day yesterday. 7 of 9 from the floor, 3 three-pointers. Against Lithuania, the United States trailing 15-13, and here is the junior to be from Petersburg, Virginia, all Big 12 second teamer this past season, a 15 point per game average at the tournament. Comes up well short on the first try.
And Mason logging a lot of minutes because we mentioned the injuries to two Kansas players, Devontae Graham and Brandon Green.
Yeah, that big one, Graham, got injured on June 17th. Bill Self and his staff had to scramble, and they called on Julian DeBose from Florida Gulf Coast University as a late replacement.
And also not on this trip, Zvi Mikhailik, the shooter, but he's from the Ukraine, so not eligible to play for Team USA. And also Shek Diallo, the McDonald's All-American freshman, is from Mali, so he is not on this trip.
Gudemak, the 19-footer, batted out by Seldon, U.S. at the track meet, and Moore will stop on a dime and hand it off to Vic down the lane and sent away by Gudemak. Here comes Russia blazing a trail down the floor, and it's Strebkov operating on the near sideline. Working on Traylor.
An isolation on the big man.
Coming down the lane, hangs over Lucas, just rolls off, but chased down by Russia, and it's Gudemak with the rebound. Strebkov, who plays with CSKA Moscow, two-time league champion with them. Three-pointer off the mark for Nikita Barinov. And the United States can take the lead with 48 seconds to go. Traylor drops the ball, steps on the baseline, and the U.S. turning it over.
Well, exceptional pass by Vic as he tries to thread the needle.
Coming in, Carlton Bragg taking out Jamari Traylor.
There's a little example of the physical play international ball as Vic tries to attack the rim and runs into a big body. No whistle.
Artem Fikrov coming on for the Russians. He spells Viktor Zariajko, and Team Russia with possession. 42 seconds to go. Strebkov, number 19, with the ball, coming around the screen by Gudemak. In the corner, Ilnitsky for three, and he gets another one to go. That's his second three of the quarter. He's got 8 points.
Well, Nick Moore got caught inside, somewhat watching the paint dry, late recovery with his size, not able to contest.
Bragg the lob underneath to Lucas, who just misfires from point-blank range in the final possession of the quarter for Russia.
Well, excellent high-low by Team USA, which Bill Self prides himself in. Bragg delivers, but Lucas not able to convert.
Strebkov in a step in three, and Vic nearly touched it over the cylinder. Seldon from 60, and it's just wide. 18-14, Russia on top of the United States. A place in the gold medal game at stake. Back with more. We begin the second quarter of play from Gwangju, South Korea. Danny Lee, Kevin Lehman with you. Nick Moore shuttling the ball ahead. Mason, Seldon, Bragg, and Ellis, the five, four of the five starters. Bragg the lone non-starter. Acrobatic play for Seldon.
Seldon on the baseline, floating like helium.
Three-point shot just rolls off the iron for Pavel Antipov. Rebound taken by Desiatnikov, the 7'3 big man for Russia. A lot of size, not a whole lot of bulk, but has caused the U.S. problems.
Acrobatic move by the junior, Wayne Selden Jr.
Rush a ball. Here comes Strebkov right through the tandem of Bragg and Ellis, no less. On the other end, Ellis blocked by Desiatnikov and the rebound tracked down by Antipov.
Ellis at 6'8". Got great position, but he's given up 7 inches. Right down Main Street, number 19 there.
Strebkov inbounds to Antipov for three. He buries it, and the Russian three-point shooting is alive and well as they race out to a 23-16 lead, 58 seconds into the second period of play. Russia on top, back with more.
I'm a travel writer, discovering the world's exotic charm, cherishing each treasure untold. Asiana Airlines allows me to unearth the unique colors of the world. So I fly Asiana to Seoul and beyond.
Fly with color. Asiana Airlines.
The steady Betty.
Steady Betty.
You fired up!
Am I the only one with a meeting?
I've got to.
Yeah, we gotta go.
I gotta say it, man. This is a nice setup.
Too soon. Skip.
Nissan Sentra. J.D. Power's highest-ranked compact car in initial quality. Now get 0% financing or a great lease on the Nissan Sentra.
From inside the Gwangju Dong Kong College Gymnasium, Russia on top 23-16, 8 points for Ilnitsky, a couple of three-point makes, 4 points for Selden, and we have the remnants of a typhoon outside. It's been pouring rain all day long. It's been pouring threes so far to this point for Russia, and as we continue to say, just outside the Russian three-point arc, in between timeouts, they were cleaning up rain leaking from the roof.
Yeah, at half court, you can see the two young men with towels that run out there every chance they get.
Wayne Selden Jr. with the three-pointer, and he's got 7 points for the United States, cutting the lead down to four.
Now, Ilnitsky. Last time out, Wayne Selden Jr. took his jersey off, and the manager wiped him down like a boxer, wiping the sweat off. That's how humid it is in this arena. But Wayne Selden Jr., rise, release, ripples the net.
U.S. just 1-for-8 on three-point shots in the first quarter. Working inside to Desiatnikov. Boy, and the slam dunk misses. Saved, though, and blocked again by Bragg, defensing both times. And a foul in the front court against the Russians.
Again, a tactic we see often. But watch this spray down here. Great inside-outside. He tries to throw it through. The rim springs back. And then the freshman, Carlton Bragg, says, get that out of here, 7'3", man.
Excellent play by Strebkov to save it as well. Ellis from the corner. His three-pointer is good.
Well, we talked about the stretch threes of this Russian team. Perry Ellis can make that three ball. We'll need to today.
United States on a 6-0 run on those 2 3-point shots. And now free throws upcoming for Vasily Karasov's team. There's a look at Vasily. He was a world silver medalist on the 94 Russian team, which, among others, faced the United States team that had Shaq, Gary Payton, Joe Dumars, Dominique Wilkins, finishing second.
And you can see that last bucket by Perry Ellis set up by Wayne Selden's penetration. He draws traffic. Strebkov comes off the bench for this Russian team, but he is their leading scorer, just over 10 a game. This Russian team has unbelievable balanced scoring.
Strebkov's a perfect 15 of 15 at the line at these games, and it's a 25-22 lead for the Russians. Here's Ellis. Drops it off low to Seldon. Dribble weave with DeBose. Back again to Ellis. Seldon eyes the rim. Shoots the three. Misses. And Desi Otnikoff reels in the rebound. Here comes Strebkov. Throws it away. Ball on the floor. Who wants it? Squirts through the hands of Strebkov. And it's DeBose. He can't call a timeout, remember. International play. Only the coach can call a timeout. It's a held ball. That courtesy of Desi Otnikoff. And it goes Russia's way, and the crowd applauding the effort.
That's an excellent point now in international ball. And we're going to see this in the college game next year. Players cannot call a timeout, so there are going to be more scrums.
Hunter Mickelson back on for the United States. He picked up two early fouls. And at midcourt, a host of volunteers cleaning up all the sweat stains left by the trail of bodies. Look at Vasily Karasov. He played for Sergei Belov on those Worlds teams. Another look at that last scrum.
Seldon punched it. You think these two teams aren't playing for keeps? They're not wearing tuxedos today, Danny. They are on the floor getting dirty.
And you see what we're talking about, cleaning up the water as it has begun to rain, presumably outside again. And now the Kansas support staff getting down and dirty as well, cleaning up all the water stains on the court. Certainly that's a safety issue. Above us, in between the Germany-Brazil game and this one, they fixed the ceiling with a ramp-like device leading into a paint bucket. Apparently that little MacGyver-like trick that we were talking about hasn't really worked wonders.
It's a 5-gallon bucket in the rafters with somewhat of a rain spout looking device attached to it.
Oh, and that turned into an alley-oop, perhaps not by design, but Strebkov ends up feeding Desi Otnikoff, who's got 3 points for the Russians, and on the baseline, Seldon, almost a 60% shooter in the games, an air ball, Desi Otnikoff on Ellis. Mickelson gets a piece.
Well, Desi Otnikoff, that time with a hand up, disrupted Wayne Seldon's jumper.
Good ball movement to Mason for three.
Excellent. A plane the second side. Bring it up and reverse it. Seldon with the step in three. High percentage shot, the step in three ball.
4 3-pointers made for the U.S., three coming in the quarter. Weaving down the lane, Vikrov. Mickelson defending the shot. On the ground, the ball. Desi Otnikoff tangled up with Ellis. And they're going to call it a held ball. This time the United States will keep possession.
I watched the Russians play Estonia, and there you can see, again, a battle for a loose basketball.
Well, it's interesting. They called it a held ball, but that's not really a held ball. It's the shoe of Desi Otnikoff wrapping up the ball.
Here's that lob play as Desi Otnikoff finishes it with authority. Now, I watched this Russian team play Estonia yesterday, and Desi Otnikoff is playing with much more intensity at both ends of the floor than he did against this team from Estonia as he sees that red, white, and blue taking his game to another level.
Yeah, USA, Russia, no matter what the sport, no matter what the playing surface, has a tendency to bring out the best in the players out on the field of play. And Ellis straight to the hoop, drawing the foul, and a chance for a 3-point play. And this is the type of play we were expecting from the senior to be for Kansas.
Well, I like that he attacked the 7-foot-3 player. Put it on the deck. Ellis, multi-dimensional for Team USA. The senior out of Wichita, Kansas.
He's got
Wichita
9
Heights
points.
High School.
And drops through the free throw to give him double figures, led the team in scoring and rebounding this last season at 14-7 thereabouts. So the U.S. has its first lead at 28-27 at the 6-minute mark here in the second. Pass from Strebkov squirts right out of the hands of Antipov. Here comes Mason, and he's fouled going by Antipov.
Now, Bill Self's teams are always known for intense on-ball pressure. They've been successful throughout this tournament with the quick hands of this Team USA. Something that these international teams are not used to is the quickness. Smaller in stature, but Mason and Moore have been very effective. And that time, LeBose in the action.
Oh, nice pass from Seldon, and it's thrown down by Hunter Mickelson for his first field goal.
Well, Seldon, like the Swiss Army knife, he can do a little bit of everything for you.
Komoloff against DeBose. And again, the ball squirts through the hands, this time of Ilnitsky. Back to Komoloff. Driving on DeBose, scoops it up. Not there, and Mickelson grabs another. Here's Mason into the front court. Down the lane. Tipped in by Mickelson.
Well, this whole tournament's been a coming out party for Hunter Mickelson.
The U.S. rolling up by five here in the second quarter of the semifinals. Hunter Mickelson helping to lead the charge for the United States, which has scored more points already through the first 4 minutes and 45 seconds of the second quarter than they did the entire first 10-minute first quarter of play. They're outscoring the Russians on a 10-0 run here.
Hunter Mickelson, soft hands. Young man out of Jonesboro, Arkansas, transfer from Arkansas into the KU program.
Russia cannot hold onto the ball at this point. Alley-oop to Seldon. Look out below.
The defensive pressure by Team USA is really bothering this team from Russia.
Three-point shot for Artem Komolov, and that ends a 12-0 run for the U.S. And the Russians with another three-pointer, their fifth.
Now Komolov stops the bleeding temporarily.
Russians went from seven up, and until that field goal, were down by six, or make it seven. 14-point switch already in the early stages of this game. Here's Mason, outlet to Ellis. Step-back jumper over Komolov, and it just drops off the iron. Up the floor comes Vikrov. Cross-court feed, Komolov. Gudumak also on the floor with Ilnitsky and Vikrov, the five for the Russians. Yeah, packed house, and their voices are being heard right now. Nice play from DeBose, and it hit the knee of Mickelson. But right now, the United States swarming defensively and holding the Russians in check.
How about this? Up in the air. Frank Mason delivers. And Wayne Seldon finishes it. That is taking the elevator to the top floor.
That's going to be a fun tandem to watch, just based on what they've shown here alone this coming season with the development of Seldon and how well he's played here. Ball amounted to Gudumak, and they're going to say on the inbounds, it looks like he may have stepped over the line.
Well, Team USA has struggled with the out-of-bounds plays of Russia underneath the Russian basket, have given up one layup and there almost another if the pass had not hit the inline.
Frank Mason the third around the screen from Traylor. As in the backcourt, they're wiping up the water dripping down from the ceiling here in this venue. Good defense from Russia's Artem Vikrov. And it's going to be a foul against Team USA on the turnover.
Freshman Vic with a soft pass and tries to get it back. We talked about these two freshmen now. Vic and Carlton Bragg are learning a new language as they play for Team USA. The experienced other players from the University of Kansas, or as in the case of Nick Moore and Julian DeBois, they played for a coach that's familiar with this KU program.
Komolov, right of the lane in the corner, three-point shot off the mark for Barinov. And a put back by Gudumak. He gets blocked. More defense being shown from the U.S. Mason will step it back out.
Well, DeBois got a piece of that.
DeBose, the outlet to Vic. Ball fake. Now working on the taller Barinov. Mason with five on the shot clock. Trying to shake Komolov. Floats to the right baseline. but gets fouled and will get a trip to the line for two, all expenses paid.
The lateral quickness of Frank Mason has been a problem for teams throughout this tournament. You see that cross between the legs, a little shake and bake. See ya. Going by you now. And create some contact. And at the free throw line.
Frank Mason, the third of the line, and the Rosie chants that we heard so many times in Kazan, Russia at the last World University Games, now coming out of the rafters. Mason with 7 first half points. He had scored double figures in 21 straight games at one point this past season, 30 times overall for Kansas. And it just falls off the right side of the rim to keep the U.S. lead at 5. Bikroff spins around. Russia basketball, semifinal game. The winner plays Germany tomorrow for the gold. Zariashko on his way to the hoop. Tipped by Mason, loose ball. Goes to Gudemach. Three-pointer well off, and Traylor snatches the rebound, going to Seldon. Up ahead to Mason with 2:40 left. Mickelson tied up in a foul on Gudemach, and that's the 5th on the Russians.
International basketball, as we mentioned, it'll be 2 shots, no one-on-ones, 2 shots for the rest of the quarter for both of these teams.
Yeah, it's the old one-and-one NBA variety. Automatic 2 shots. And Mickelson to the line, 5 of 7 from the charity stripe in the tournament. And the 5th-year senior upcoming from Jonesboro, Arkansas. He was 13 of 15 this past year for Kansas.
Bill Self mentioned that he had to take Russia, or his team had to take Russia out of their sets. And Team USA has done that with tremendous ball pressure. They've gone over the top of ball screens, fought through the contact, and it has disrupted the ball movement of the Russians.
Yeah, you can go back to what Vasily Karasov told us about his thoughts on the United States team, the team that plays together more so than the USA select team. From Kazan, all the way down comes Vic, and the freshman hammers it home. Put the USA on top of the Russians, 38-30 with 2:25 to go in the second quarter. Defense and a little bit of highlight action for USA. Early returns on the stats, United States out shooting Russia 44-33%, and with the advantage on the glass in favor of the Russians.
But Gerald Vick with an excellent performance. It allows Nick Moore to get some rest on the bench. He'll need his ball handling skills in the second half.
On the wing, here comes Antipov. Gives away his dribble. Strebkov. And the Russians cannot hang on to the ball in this half. Just over 2 minutes to go. Strebkov off the dribble. Runs over Mason. Nothing called. And Strebkov with 8 first half points. Came in averaging 10.2 a game as Russia's leading scorer.
Well, they scored that time on Team USA's defense, but the pressure on the ball we've seen intensify each game in this tournament by the team in blue.
Traylor loses it out of bounds, and back to Team Russia will go. The winner will play Germany, and as if you missed our Germany-Brazil semifinal broadcast, Henrik Hertel played for University of North Carolina, and Dean Smith won a national championship there. So certainly an interesting storyline as the Germans have 5 players who have either played or are playing Division I basketball. But back out on the floor, another 3-point shot, the 6th of the game for Russia.
Well, if they had instant replay, that would have been a 2, Danny, because his foot was on the line. As the official looked across court, they both signaled 3, and neither knew where the foot was at.
And Strebkov with another one. Another 3-point shot to tie it up.
Now Ellis goes down hard. He slips on water on the court. As now the official, they're trying to clean it up.
Ivan Strebkov putting on a shooting clinic, back-to-back 3-point shots. 38-37, and actually gonna take away one of his threes, and they make that one that you mentioned right before the break, Kevin. A 2-point shot, so it is still a 1-point lead for USA, but Strebkov with 13 points to lead all scorers. Ellis back out on the floor, stops on a dime, turns around and buries the jump hook.
Perry Ellis I've mentioned time and time again. Excellent footwork as he makes a full pivot and is able to score on balance over the 7 foot three Russian.
And the AP All-American having perhaps his best performance of the games with 12 points in the front court of travel called against Selden.
And the look on Wayne Selden's face as this happened to him numerous times in the game 2 days ago against Lithuania. He doesn't get that pivot foot down. It's called closer in international play than in the college game.
We saw that look against Lithuania, and on the next play basically hits a three and then goes off, and the United States ran Lithuania out of the gym. We'll see if that rears its head here again. Here's Vic, U.S. by three. Ellis matched up with Artem Klimenko, the other seven-footer on the Russian roster. Nice move by Ellis.
Now, if you go to a practice, Team USA or the University of Kansas, you're going to see those posts work on that move time and time again. Perry Ellis has perfected it in the low block.
Three-pointer from Antipov off the mark, but a foul before the clock expires, and it looks like Selden is going to be called as the aggressor, and the United States out of foul, so Russia will have free throws before we go to halftime on Selden's first foul.
And Nick Moore picked up his third, so he's been on the bench. Gerald Vick has gotten minutes here in the second quarter because of that foul issue with Moore, and that's one thing Bill Self said, my guards cannot get in foul trouble. Now Selden talked to the official about getting hooked on that play.
And because there's no instant replay here, no way of figuring out how much time is left on the clock, the officials let the clock go dead, and free throws for Klimenko with nobody on the lines. His first point of the game, plays for club team Avtodar Saratov in the tournament, averaging 6.5 points, 2.5 rebounds per game, is 13 of 19 at the line. And he ends the first half on a positive note for the Russians, which had their hands full in the first half. Bill Self waiting for Perry Ellis to break out in the first 20 minutes, Kevin. Ellis leading the way with 14 points.
I like the way Perry Ellis has attacked the post players, even though he's given up inches to the 7 foot three, Desi Antonov. He still is on the attack and has been successful.
Team Russia won gold in Kazan, beating Australia in the final, and a very high-scoring second quarter after what was not a so sublime first quarter for either team in the offensive department. The U.S. on the laurels of that 10-0 run at one point, 15-4, they raced out to the lead. The Russians came back with a couple of threes from Strebkov, and were in a tightly knit contest for the three-point game at the halfway mark.
Well, the defensive pressure by Team USA stepped up in the second quarter. That allowed them to get the lead, but then the three ball by Russia.
47% shooting for the United States, 6 threes for Russia, 4 for the U.S. Rebounding margin favored the Russians 21-19. The Russians with 9 assists on 14 field goals, 7 on 16 for the U.S., and both teams with 7 turnovers in that first half, Kevin.
The U.S. with only one offensive rebound. We talked about the front line size of Russia as really limiting to just one shot. You get a look at some highlights. There's a first basket of the game as Ellis gets a run out.
And the U.S. going to the well with Ellis early and often, but then Selden providing the highlight-worthy plays.
But there's a great ball move by the Russian team as they have drilled the three-point line. Again and again, tardy on the recovery by Team USA.
6 3-pointers in the first half, 2 for that man right there, Stanislav Ilnitsky. But Selden up to the challenge as well. He had 9 first half points.
Now Nick Moore sat a lot, but there's Selden with penetration, drawing defenders. Ellis lights it up from outside.
And Perry Ellis doing it early and doing it often for the U.S., already passing his scoring average at the games. And it was the big man for the Russians, Andrei Desyatnikov, also making his name heard, as has Hunter Mickelson here in South Korea.
Oh, Mickelson at a coming out party, we've said time and time again here. So you can see him, an excellent offensive rebounder for Team USA.
Frank Mason with the alley oop to Wayne Selden Jr., who hammered it home.
Selden rising like yeast to throw that one down.
But the Russians making a couple of mistakes on their own end, and LeGerald Vick able to provide some defense and put in some of his own highlight caliber plays. And it's 42-39 at the half. U.S. on top of the hot shooting Russians. The USA and Russia trying to vie for a piece of the gold medal game against Germany. And just as an aside here, we just got an update from track and field. The United States winning its 51st medal at these games, a new World University Games record, Kevin. And all along we've been talking about the context, the basketball, the World University Games. But a lot of credit and a big shout out has to go to BTI. They put these teams together. They ensure years in advance the United States is the most competitive teams on the various fields of play. Swimming pulled home 34 medals. The U.S. trying to pick up its first gold medal since 2005. And not only that, the lead up to the tournament, but also at the tournament, making sure the athletes get to where they need to be and making sure everything goes off smoothly. And the guys like Nels Håkansson, executive director, Craig Jonas, Brian Ratzliff, so many names to mention. But they do such an amazing job, such a behind-the-scenes effort, but they cannot be thanked enough for helping to put together the U.S. cause at these games.
And when you say BTI, you're referring to Basketball Travelers, Inc. They take numerous teams overseas in the summer. I think they had almost 20 teams going to Italy.
Yeah, 35
in August.
35 teams this summer in total over 30 days. How about that for logistics? Ilnitsky had a couple of threes in the first half. Misses off short. And I have to thank Nels Håkansson, too, for bringing me lunch up here today. He does it all, folks. Ellis, the dive play to the hoop, and he continues what he started in the first half. He has 16 points now for the United States. Best scoring effort by far.
Well, he's continued to take the bigs, especially Desi Otnikoff, out on the perimeter and just dribble drive by him.
Starters back on the floor for both teams. Block from behind, Antipop, good play for Mickelson, the block shot artist. A lob for Mason, looking for Ellis, tipped away, and it's taken by Artem Komolov, defense by LeGerald Vick. The one non-starter for the U.S., Vick starts the second half. Nick Moore got into foul trouble in the first half of play and does not come out to start the second half.
Vick with some excellent minutes in the first half for Team USA.
Mickelson wrenching away the rebound from Desi Otnikoff. Here's Vick double-teamed. Mason, defense by Ilnitsky. Ellis, eyeing the rim, drives on the 7-3, big man, short, and it's Desi Otnikoff with the rebound.
Well, Ellis at 6'8", we mentioned it before, he's actually giving up 7 inches to the big man from Russia, Desi Otnikoff.
On the wing, it's Ivan Strebkov, the leading scorer for Russia in the first half with 13 points. Antipov runs out of room. Ilnitsky, another three. No, this one long. And Vick latches onto the rebound. Here's Seldon.
So important for Team USA guards to get in the fray and rebound as Vick did that time. Mason has rebounded well along with Moore.
Ellis, that stop in the paint, but this time blocked. And the Russians away with possession. Strebkov nearly traveled behind the line. The shot rolls off. And good play for Ilnitsky to salvage it for the Russians, which will make a substitution right now.
You see that ball coming off Ellis. And last trip up, Ellis actually lost the handle or the grip on the basketball. We've talked about the humidity in this gymnasium.
Artem Vikrov on for the Russians. Nice lob inside. Strebkov this time playing the role of distributor, getting it to Desi Otnikoff, who has 6 points.
And Desi Otnikoff made that look easy. Looked like you and I on the 8-foot hoop in our driveway.
Better make mine 6. Mickelson on the wing. Mason against Strebkov around the rub from Mickelson. 3-point shot, he's got it.
Boy, Mason is so smooth when he comes off that ball screen because he has broke some ankles, so you'll see the Russian defenders back up. Frank Mason, excellent concept of pace and space.
U.S. and Russia meeting at a World University Games for the first time since 2009, a 1-point win for Russia. Then Ball tipped. Good play for Mickelson. Another block on the wing. Three-pointer at the horn for Strebkov. It will stay with Russia, but keep in mind, no possession change. So the shot clock simply resets to 14 as per international rules.
Well, I love the defensive effort by Vic, but there's that lob play, the 7'3" Russian. And now Nick Moore back in. There's Mason off that ball screen. Score up and splashes it through from the top of the key.
The U.S., the best three-point shooting team in the tournament at 36%. They've got 5 three-pointers made today. Right wing three for Komolov. Not there. Ball batted out to Antipov.
That was one of the concerns for Bill Self, his ability to shoot the three ball.
Oh, what a play by Strebkov to roll it in. He now has 15 points for the Russians.
As Brandon Green was left home with the injury and Devontae Graham on the trip and not able to play, thought they would lack an ability to shoot the three, but they have shot it well in this tournament.
Ellis denied by Desiatnikov with the block, standing flat-footed, no less. The reverse layup. Komolov can't get it to go. Out of the scrum comes Mason, and a foul against the Russians going on Komolov. It looks like it's going to be his third foul of the contest.
Well, this first half has been two heavyweight boxers delivering blows back and forth. No one getting an advantage in the first 2 minutes.
On the floor comes Alexander Gudumak, number 6. He takes out Antipov in your screen. Antipov with 6 first half points on a couple of three-pointers, and they'll be wiping up the floor, so momentary delay.
And Carlton Bragg Jr. back in the lineup for Team USA. And we talked about the USA on the front of the jerseys. On the shorts, you see KU. Most of his team is made up of University of Kansas Jayhawk players.
All but 2 from Kansas. Moore and DeBose. Moore from SMU. DeBose from Florida Gulf Coast University. Russia basketball off the miss. Here comes Strebkov. Komolov. Desiatnikov. Gudumak. And Vikrov, the 5 for Team Russia. 7 on the shot clock. Desiatnikov! And Mickelson nearly had another block, but this time gets a piece of the arm. The 7'3" Russian.
And that is the third on Mickelson, as you see Landon Lucas jump up and pull the jersey off. I like Mickelson with the challenge on the big Russian.
Mickelson, who once set the freshman record at Arkansas in his first season there in 2011-2012 with those 72 blocks. Set of the line goes Desiatnikov. 6 points, went 1-for-2 at the line in the first half, and is now 15 of 20 at the line at the games.
Well, Desiatnikov, a much more of a factor in today's game than he was yesterday against Lithuania. Actually, that was 2 days ago. He has taken it to another level at the defensive end.
Desiatnikov and Zakharov just came back from the United States. They were in the NBA draft as international potential selections, but they were not selected, and then came from the U.S. straight to this Russian team for the World University Games. 3-point lead for the U.S. Just over 5 minutes to go. Baseline jumper. Nothing but the bottom of the net for Seldon. Into double figures as the third U.S. player in double figures, along with Ellis 16 and Mason's 10, 11 for Seldon.
I was just about to say Seldon had been quiet here in this second half, and he delivers right on cue.
Vikrov, he goes baseline to Gudumak against Moore. And Lucas matched up with Desiatnikov, bumps him, and will get called for the foul. So the big man back to the line for Russia.
You see Nick Moore trying to wall up as he gives away a foot inside on that post up. There's the challenge by Lucas.
And the 7'3" Desiatnikov, you look at Lucas, he's 6'10". He's still giving away 5 inches.
Yeah, Desiatnikov, just a 57% free throw shooter.
He's at 4 points, 5 boards per game in the first 6 games for Russia coming in. 49-45 the score. Desiatnikov with 7, the leader for the Russian Strebkov with 15. more Bragg, along with Lucas, Mason, and Seldon, the five for Team USA. 4.5 minutes to go in the third period. The winner will take on Germany at Yomju Gymnasium tomorrow for the gold. Lucas inside, puts it in. Oh, and Seldon clocks Klimenko, and nothing whistled on the rebound try.
Well, Landon Lucas has struggled to score points, but he scores on the seven-footer as Klimenko replaces Desyatnyov.
Nice runner to the cup for Vikrov. First points of the second half. He's got six, and the U.S. maintaining a four-point lead. Into the corner goes Moore. Lucas drifts outside the arc, and it'll be Mason at the controls for the United States. Took the lead in the second quarter and haven't looked back since. Tipped away by Zaryajko, number nine, the captain for Russia. Member of the Kazan team 2 years ago.
Vikov trying to deny the ball back to Frank Mason when he gives it up, because Mason has done some damage against this Russian defense, especially coming off high ball screens.
The Russians beating the Estonians in the quarterfinals. The United States knocking off the Lithuanians to get to this point. Bragg's three rims out. Rebound retrieved by Gudumak. And here comes Zaryajko shuttling the ball down the floor. Bragg in defense.
And Bragg with a broken nose, played with a mask for two games, then left it, tossed it aside, and played without it.
Bragg, another block over the back of the backboard for Klimenko. Tried the famous Larry Bird shot to no avail.
Now when Frank Mason gives up the ball, Vikov, well, let's take a look at this one. The block over the top, the seven-footer. Can't get it over the backboard, but they're trying to face guard Frank Mason, not let him get a touch back once he gives it up.
Do I dare say, Kevin, that shot was nothing but net for Russia? Inside Lucas, falling off balance, lays it in and draws the foul.
Landon Lucas with that big body able to pin. Great ball reversal by Team USA. And a perfectly delivered lob pass by Frank Mason.
The foul against Strebkov. And Lucas has had a fantastic time inside. Probably no walk in the park with all the size he's had to contend with. First against Lithuania, now having a battle with the 2 7-footers on Russia's side.
And Lucas with some fresh legs because of the depth of the front line of Team USA. That's been the strength for Team USA, has been in the end of the third, fourth quarter. Let's hope it continues today as Bill Self tries to bring in fresh bodies.
Largest lead of the game for the United States at 7, and a turnover now. Vikrov called for an offensive foul, now talking with his coach, Vasily Karasov, after pushing off. We've seen that swim maneuver, that hook move in the first semifinal, and now in this game being called. And it's an offensive foul against the Russians. We're back to the USA.
Well, Frank Mason has been an iron man. He has played many minutes here for Team USA. You see, again, they're trying to deny Frank the ball. They want it in his hands.
Bragg head fake, stutter step dribble. Tipped up by Lucas.
Lucas making an impact for Team USA.
He's got 7 points, matching his total from the game against Lithuania. 9-point game in favor of the U.S. How do the Russians respond? On the move, Vikrov to the cup.
Vikrov with an excellent move and underhand scoop.
Mason moving inside. Over to Lucas. Backing down Antipov, spins baseline, drops it off to Bragg. Nice play.
Now Lucas felt the pressure from the help side defender, knew that his other post partner, Carlton Bragg, would be in position. Dishes the dime.
Behind the back, poked away by Moore, and a foul in the front court. And you had one of the staff here who has been cleaning up the dripping roof. He had a run off the court. Boy, frustrating times for a sit for Vasily Karasov and the reigning World University Games champion Russia, down by 9 points. United States leading 58-49 over Russia here in the semifinals. Perry Ellis, the leading scorer for the USA, with 16 points, leading three double-digit scores. But Landon Lucas asserting himself inside.
Working on the glass. Lucas, and now a little post move inside to spin, the dump. Carlton Bragg with the finish.
Lucas, outlet, Mason, jumper, his foot was on the line. Seldon for three, and he sticks it for the USA. He with 14 points now, making the three-point jumper his second of the game.
And who with the offensive rebound? Landon Lucas.
Going down the lane, stripped Strebkov. Ball on the floor. Moore trying to pick it up, but it will stay with the Russians with a minute eight to go. And this game is starting to take on a similar tenor to what we saw against the Lithuanians, Kevin. The U.S. making a run late stage of the third period.
Boy, look at the effort by Seldon. He's going to take a seat on the stage. And the Russian coach, Karlsov, made the comment to us that this was not a USA All-Star team. They were more together as a team, and it is a team comprised mainly of Jayhawks from the University of Kansas.
A team certainly that knows each other pretty well. Strebkov to the hoop, now has 17, and he said his team, well, they haven't been together a whole lot of time, not quite as experienced as the team in Kazan, which featured Sergei Karasov, the son of Vasily, and who 2 weeks prior was drafted by the Cleveland Cavaliers. That was an experienced team, had Olympians and senior national team guys on it.
Now that time, Lucas called for a foul as he runs down court, gets tangled up.
It's a 10-point lead for the United States. Waning seconds of the third period. The winner will play Germany for the gold. Strebkov, defense by Bragg. Moore, the headman pass, chased down by Zariashko. Break for the Russians, 4-on-3. Strebkov whips it up top to Ilnitsky. Into the lane, spin move Barinov, fouled by Bragg.
Well, Bragg with excellent recovery to take away the three ball. The big man learning the defensive principles of Bill Self. There's the ball move you see from this team from Russia. Bragg with the recovery, spin, little contact, and puts him on the line.
And Perry Ellis, the leading scorer, with 16 back into the game for the United States. Barinov has not scored. 13 of 15 at the line at the World University Games. And Vasily Karasov, his teams have had a reputation for a great ball movement, and that's one thing that Bill Self told us going into this game. And you mentioned a stat earlier on one possession yesterday against Estonia. They moved the ball 11 times in one shot clock period to get the bucket. It's an 8-point game.
Now 2 second differential on the shot clock. Look for Team USA to run this down and take the last one. They like to go 1-4 in this situation.
Moore sweeps right by Strebkov. Outlet to the hot hand Ellis. Dribble weave, Seldon to Ellis, back to Mason, 5 on the shot clock. Mason in the paint and goes down, but a travel is going to be called. With 4.4 seconds to go, the Russians will have one more possession.
Well, Mason turns the corner, that in-out move, but how about the pass? Finds his partner in the corner, extra step. Boy, great vision by Frank Mason, the junior.
Russians will have it three quarters court. Zariashko inbounding to Strebkov. Across midcourt from 45 feet, banks it in. Oh, what a way to end the quarter for Russia.
Well, the 5-point swing as USA failed to score. Russia with the banker.
Go into the fourth, stay with us. Ivan Strebkov, the leading scorer for Russia with 20 points, hitting the half-court shot at the horn of the third quarter. And right now, the Russians on a 7-0 run to turn what was a 12-point deficit with a minute 20 to go in the third into a 5-point game. Moore from three. That's off the mark. And the rebound slips out of the hands of Ilnitsky, but the Russians hang on and looking to further cut into the lead.
So good look by Nick Moore and a set play coming out of the timeout by Bill Self.
Nice cut for Ilnitsky, the feed from Desyatnikov. Ilnitsky now with 10 points, second Russian in double figures.
You feel the momentum turning just a bit toward Russia.
Ellis three off the front rim, and the rebound drops into the arms. Once again, a Strebkov all over the place. Wrapped up, going up by Mason. Good defense, and a foul whistled on Desiatnikov. Trying to slow down the United States, perhaps.
Mickelson again on the glass for Team USA.
A 9-0 run for the Russians. Now within 3 points of the USA. And a gold medal game spot for one of these two teams against Germany tomorrow.
Now, Team USA is able to rotate their post, and as they have five bodies for those two spots, you see Team Russia doing it with their perimeter players. Frank Mason, the Iron Man for Team USA, has played the entire second half and most of the first half.
Mason with 10 points for the U.S. Seldon goes the other way from Ellis. Kicks it back into the corner for Moore for three. That off the rim. Collision between Ellis and Mickelson. Ball squirts through the legs of Moore, hanging on with Desiatnikov. And it will be Russia basketball.
Again, bodies on the court in the scrum. Ellis had a piece of it, lost it. As Strebkov jumped in there now, the little Nick Moore going against the 7 foot three.
That's 5'9", Nick Moore against the 7'3", Desiatnikov. Ellis out of the game for the USA. Carlton Bragg in. Moore, pick it up. Mason in there with Moore, Bragg, Seldon, and Mickelson. Trouble in the backcourt. Komolov goes down, and the ball picked up by Barinov, and a foul is whistled. Komolov, Barinov, Strebkov, Desiatnikov, and Elnitsky are the five for the Russians.
And that foul goes to Carlton Bragg as Nick Moore is playing with three fouls.
The ball will be moved into the front court, so it'll be Artem Komolov. Plays with club team Zenit St. Petersburg for Karasov, who's the head coach over there. Komolov, foul line outlet, Russia ball. Here's Barinov backing down Mason. On the wing, jump pass, Ilnitsky, and Desiatnikov was not looking, and it's a turnover for the Russians.
The communication on the ball screens by Team USA have been excellent. Carlton Bragg, the freshman, made a great decision and took the ball, but left Frank Mason on the block trying to defend a bigger player. Dodged a bullet there, Team USA.
Moore straight away for the U.S. United States already setting a World University Games record on their end with 51 medals. Travel, and Bragg turns it over. The Russians, by the way, have won 109 medals, which kind of pales in comparison. They won something like 149 golds in Kazan at the World Games. Vasily Karasov coaching Stanislav Ilnitsky as he comes out of the game with 10 points. Russia still on that 9-0 run to turn a 12-point U.S. lead to three. Strebkov around the rub, ball fake, Mickelson defensing. Great play for Hunter Mickelson, and it will go right back to Team USA as Perry Ellis checks back in, and Bragg comes out at the same time that Strebkov comes off, perhaps a very short rest for the 20-point score, and Zaryazhko in for the Russians.
Team USA have struggled at the offensive end, but their defense has been excellent. They need to get into another gear here at the offensive end.
Ellis, the Wichita, Kansas native, jump hook not there, and the U.S. still dry from the floor here in the fourth quarter. Mickelson, 16-footer, rims out. So since they went up 61-49 with a minute 20 left in the third, they have not scored. Turn in the lane, Barinov rolls it in, and it's now a 10-0 run for the Russians to pull to within one, and Bill Self will call one of his three timeouts. Now, Vasily Karasov's team went down 12, but they battled back, trail only by one, 7:20 to go here in the fourth. An 11-0 run for Team Russia, and working inside, Barinov with the jump hook over Mickelson.
And Strebkov with the bank shot into the third quarter to get Russia within a nickel. The momentum has stayed with the team in white and red.
Yeah, that Strebkov shot coming from half court. And now the United States, their double-digit lead is down to just one. Lucas onto the floor for the U.S. Mason on the wing, waits for Moore off the cut. The mid-range jumper comes off, grabs his own rebound. That won't go. And the U.S. still scoreless in the fourth quarter. Here's Vikrov.
Yeah, Russians have really tightened up their defense here in the fourth quarter. That lift of that bank shot emotionally for Russia has carried to the defensive end of the floor for them.
Zaryazhko backing it out of trouble to Barinov. Comes down the lane, puts it in, and draws the foul against the disbelieving Perry Ellis.
An NBA continuation move. There's Ellis with the bump. Two more steps. They count the basket.
Barinov with 6 points, and the Russians have gone from 12 down to one up. 13-0 run. Also a member of club team Zenit St. Petersburg, missing off the back rim. Barinov, normally a very good free throw shooter at these games. USA ball now down one. On the baseline, stutter step for Seldon, step back three. He knocks down another one.
Ice in the veins of Wayne Seldon. His team needed a lift, and he gave it there in the corner pocket three ball.
17 points, 3 three-pointers for Seldon. Desiatnikov off balance. Lucas the defense. Here comes Seldon working on Zaryazhko.
Seldon loses the handle, but then picks it back up. 5-point run by Wayne Seldon Jr.
And the Russians saw their run, now met with one by the U.S., back ahead by four. Russia, the reigning World University Games champions, going on a 13-0 run to take a 1-point lead in the quarter. But the man in the middle, as Wayne Seldon Jr., a 5-0 run on his own end to now give him 19 points and to jettison the United States right back past the Russians, ahead by four with 6 minutes and change to go in the fourth quarter, with the winner going on to the gold medal game tomorrow.
Now, if Team USA can make a stop, it will keep the momentum in their favor.
Russia basketball. Here's Strebkov back out onto the floor. He's got 20 points to lead all scorers in this game. Ball right through Zaryazhko's hands, and the U.S. will pick it up on the turnover by Russia. That is their 14th turnover of the game.
Excellent job by Team USA of icing the ball screen, the side ball screen. The Russians did not know how to handle it, created a turnover.
Landon Lucas out on the perimeter to Mason. Here's Moore in stride, and another big shot for Team USA. Moore with five, and it's now a 7-0 run for the United States to go back up by six.
The little guy is fearless. Number three out of SMU, Nick Moore.
Zaryazhko on the wing. Gudemach for three. Rebound to Vikrov, and he'll lay it in, and it's a goaltending for Perry Ellis.
Now, international rules, you can goaltend in the cylinder, but there's Ellis. Once it hits the glass, you cannot goaltend it.
5 minutes to go in the United States with a 4-point lead. Here's Seldon off the Lucas screen. Well defended there by Vikrov. Ellis inside, puts it in over Gudemach.
We've talked about the footwork of the senior from Wichita Heights High School, again on display. Excellent back-end pivot move.
19 apiece for Seldon and Ellis. Down the lane. Nice job of getting the shot up by Strebkov, and he'll go to the line with the Russians down once again by six. We got the fans chanting back and forth for Russia and the United States. What else would you expect in an encounter between these two countries on the world stage, and a gold medal game to the victor?
And the rim protector, 7'3", Desiatnikov, back in for the Russians. as Ellis has scored on their 6'9 post player.
That's the first missed free throw at the games for Strebkov, who had been 15 of 15, and Vasily Karasov. His team won the gold medal 2 years ago, but a lot of thinking being done over there as the Russians missing two free throws, and now the United States will take back possession.
The wide lane makes it difficult to block out. Team USA dodged a bullet there as that almost went off Perry Ellis's hands.
The U.S. has not even had the opportunity to play for a gold medal in a decade, and they're 4:25 from getting there. Ellis head fake, drives by Desiatnikov, but travels.
Oh, and Bill Self unhappy with that call. Check the pivot foot. Just a slight shuffle.
Moritz Reida, the assistant referee on the baseline, making the call. On the drive to the hoop, missing on the layup, Zadiajko, but two free throws. All expenses paid on the foul by Team USA. Zadiajko, one of the three returners from the World University Games team from 2 years ago for Russia, plays for their professional team in the VTB United. Krasnye Krylya misses on the free throw, and that is three consecutive misses at the line for normally sure-handed Russian team. And you see four fouls against Nick Moore. One more and his day is done.
And four team fouls against Team USA, just one against Russia.
Next one will send Russia to the line. Seldon runs into the 7'3" big man for Russia. Driving on Desiatnikov and throws it home.
Oh my.
Yeah, we saw Nels Håkansson on the left side of the screen, the BTI executive director who we talked about earlier. Helps headman the U.S. effort at these World University Games. 7-point lead for the United States. They went up 12 at the end of the third. Saw the Russians come back, take a 1-point lead. Now U.S. trying to put this one away. Bank shot high off the glass. Zariajko not there. Seldon reels it in. 3:20 to go in front of a packed house here at the Dongkang College Gymnasium in South Korea. Danny Lee, Kevin Lehman with you. The winner moves on to the gold medal game against Germany. Mason sent away by Desiatnikov, and the Russians in transition. Here comes Vikrov, wrapped up by Seldon, foul number five. So free throws coming for the Russians.
How about Seldon? Goes baseline. Calls a meeting at the penthouse, and he is the first to arrive. Gets there before the 7'3" Desiatnikov.
Seldon almost pulling a Vince Carter over Frederick Weiss dunk right there from way back in the day. 2:54 to go. Big free throws for Russia. They've missed three of their last four. Vikrov. And this is the same thing that we saw from Brazil in the first semifinal, just unable to hit the free throws down the stretch.
Now important for Team USA to block out the wide lane. You got to get a body on the offensive rebounder quickly.
Vikrov, not a good free throw shooter. 5 of 15 coming in. He's got 11 points now. 6-point U.S. lead with 2:50 to go in this semifinal here in the fourth quarter.
Well, that time, the last possession, USA a little slow to initiate their offense. This 24-second clock, you got to get into it quick.
Seldon tied up with Ilnitsky. It's only the second foul on Russia.
Seldon down hard, walking it off. The big man tries to turn the corner.
Got a timeout called by Team USA. They'll have one remaining, as do the Russians. US 72, Russia 66, 2:38 in the fourth. A lot of the fans wearing Team USA in Kansas colors, both sharing red, white, and blue shades. It's a 6-point U.S. lead, and the United States onto the floor with Mason, Moore, Seldon, Lucas, and Ellis. The Russians countering with Strebkov, Ilnitsky, Desyatnikov, Vikrov, and Komolov as their five.
And the shot clock resets at 14 to go quickly, USA.
Here's Mason for the U.S., pounding the hardwood. He's got 10 points today. Ellis, 19 today. The runner not there. Oh, and Lucas went up high and came down hard. Ellis grabs the rebound, and Lucas back on his feet.
And again, shot clock resets at 14, international ball.
Quick spin for Mason. Rebound taken by Desyatnikov. And here come the Russians down six. On the wing, Vikrov floats into the corner. Ilnitsky against Ellis turns around. The jump hook with the right hand not there. And the rebound grabbed on the weak side by Mason with a minute 55 to go.
Mason, 5'11", but an outstanding rebounder at the defensive end.
Drops it off to Lucas. He'll move it around to Seldon.
And Frank Mason is tired. He has played the entire second half. Seldon's going to have to take this over.
Mason, the runner, off the back rim. Rebound flagged down by Komolov. Here come the Russians up the near side. Spin move, Vikrov runs out of real estate. Ilnitsky, three-pointer block from Komolov. Good defense. Seldon dives headfirst into the front court in the process. And now Mason trying to work some clock. Under duress from Vikrov. Drops it off to Ellis, who puts it through.
Frank Mason is running on fumes, but he continues to make plays for Team USA.
And Perry Ellis with 21 points, putting together two great halves. Mason working it here for the USA. Well, this second half can be boiled down to a couple of big runs. The Russians went down 12 at the end of the third quarter, went on a 13-0 run to go up one. But since the U.S. with a 13-4 run on their own to go back up by eight and trying to finish off Team Russia, go to the gold medal game in the lane. Strebkov puts it in and draws the foul. And hold on a second. Are they going to say an offensive foul? They're going to call Strebkov for an offensive foul. And that is a huge blow for Team Russia.
Perry Ellis got the switch on to Strebkov. Excellent defense by the post player on the guard. Drew the foul. Big turnover.
Russia with just three fouls. We'll see if they try to extend this contest. They still need to foul two more times to send U.S. to the line. Strebkov with the hip check. And Seldon goes down. That's foul number four.
An international play. 8 seconds to get it across half court. Seldon was running out of time. But resets the shot clock.
Bill Self trying to take the United States back into the gold medal game, first time since 2005.
That's huge. Now that foul was in the backcourt, so the shot clock goes to 24.
And 55.7 seconds remain with the U.S. still hanging on by 8 points as they continue to wipe off all the sweat stains on the floor, the high humidity, and the water does not evaporate as quickly, so they're making sure to dry everything off. Seldon inbounding to Mason in the backcourt. Strebkov in defense. Seldon on the near side.
And interesting, we haven't seen teams foul in international play.
Ellis airs it out. It's off to the races for Zaryazhko, who's hacked by Seldon. And two shots coming for Russia.
And not a bad foul, Danny. He made sure that he did not get the layup. Again, Wayne Seldon talked about the leadership role. That is a very intelligent play as he tries to get the clean block, but made sure the Russians didn't get a three-point play.
The Russians, who have struggled at the line, especially in the second half, just 11 for 21. And Zaryazhko hits the free throw.
He has to block
points
out. Now you're going to have a 14-second differential on the shot clock and the game clock when USA gets possession.
Second free throw good for Zaryazhko as well. U.S. by six. Moore. Strebkov. Ellis defended by Vikrov, and Ellis is wrapped up, and that will be the fifth foul on Russia. So with 33 and 1/10 to go, the United States free throw shooting prowess will be on display. Perry Ellis came in at a 6 of 13 clip, made both of his attempts earlier. Ellis tonight, 21 points, make a 20 on the nose, tied with Ivan Strebkov as the co-game leading scorers.
It's important now to make this one. It would be a three-possession game if Ellis can convert.
U.S. just 63% as a team coming in. They were 15th overall in the tournament before today.
Excellent.
Second one is good.
Concentration by Perry Ellis. Now a little pressure by Nick Moore. Takes some time off the clock as the Russians advance.
75-68 USA. Zariashko just saves that one from going out of bounds. Loses the handle on it, and Ellis grabs it. Wrapped up by Vikrov. And Ellis will be going to the opposing foul line, looking to try and put this one away as Vikrov picks off. And that's his fourth foul.
Well, Bill Self told us in the pregame, he needed a big game out of the senior, Perry Ellis. Number 34 has delivered for Team USA.
7 points here in the second half, 21 total. And it's a three-possession game right now for the U.S., with just 23 seconds to go. U.S. trying to get back, as mentioned, into the gold medal game for the first time since 2005.
And Russia out of timeout, so they cannot stop the clock on a made field goal. Take away the three ball.
Valuable seconds ticking away. Strebkov over Ellis. Just rolls off the rim. Seldon wrapped up, and that'll do it. The foul against Ilnitsky, and Team USA will be heading onto the gold medal game to take on the Germans in a matter of seconds. We're taking them on tomorrow at Yeomju Gymnasium here in Gwangju, South Korea, and the reigning gold medalist, Vasily Karasov's crown, taken away after that spirited run in the late third, early fourth quarter. The Russians just ran out of steam.
Well, made a nice run as a 12-0 run to get back into the game. Seldon does a little dance at the free throw line, and Bill Self backs his other players up behind the three-point line. Again, Wayne Seldon, 21 points, 22.
Third 20-point game at this tournament, second overall leading score, and that's it. The Russians will dribble out the clock. The Russians' gold medal not defended, as the United States will have a chance to play for their first gold medal since 2005. Final score, USA 78, Russia 68, and a very spirited effort for the Americans in the fourth quarter, Kevin, to win this one going away.
Excellent scouting report by Bill Self. He said his team had to play through contact, and they had to take Russia out of their sets. The defense was excellent by Team USA, and now an opportunity to play for the gold.
And more importantly as well, for the medal count, the United States, with the women and men playing for the golds, will add at least two more to their record haul already, which stands at 51 at these games. That's a happy group, perhaps a tired group. Wayne Seldon in the middle of it, as he always is. Perry Ellis in the background, but not in this one, in the foreground as the leading scorer with 23. He and Seldon combining for 45 of the 78, and just a great defensive performance. They've been attacked on all corners by the physical play the last few days. Lithuania, now Russia, and they've emerged victorious on both accounts.
They're excited, Bill Self. And we just give some credit to Frank Mason, who controlled the tempo of this game for Team USA and set the defensive pressure at the other end of the court for Team USA.
Team USA had a 61-49 lead with a minute 20 to go in the third period, with a half-court shot by Ivan Strebkov. It was a 62-61 lead on a 13-0 run by the Russians to go up by a point. And then after that point, the U.S., like they did with Lithuania, ran Russia out of the gym, finishing the game on a 17-6 run to win this game by 10 points.
And Team USA attacked the big men as you see Mickelson with the throwdown, but they attack the seven-footers of Russia. In the human highlight film, Wayne Selden Jr. from Roxbury, Massachusetts.
There was a half-court shot by Strebkov to pull the Russians within five. They take the lead in the third period, but the U.S. doing everything they need to do, getting on the ground, fighting for loose balls, and battling inside.
And again, the front line depth is that backup. Selden checks the line and drills it. Now how about this move? Loses the handle, regains it, kisses it off the window.
Wayne Selden Jr. started off the tournament well, 21 against Serbia, 23 against the Brazilians, and has another 20-point effort, 22 tonight against the Russians, probably the most important in its significance in sending the U.S. into the gold medal game.
And how about Mason? Tired, but still delivers. Ellis able to finish, and there is a happy group. Team USA.
Unseating the reigning World University Games champions. Team USA, one more game to go. It'll be against Germany tomorrow in South Korea for the gold medal. Final score, USA 78, Russia 68. For our great crew, for Kevin Lehman and our producer Sean Christensen, this is Danny Lee saying so long. We'll join you tomorrow. A gold medal in the balance for both the U.S. men and women. Stay with us.